going to study image formation using the convex mirror. In this case, first we were going to go through the rules of how the image formation takes place in convex, the rules that we will follow. And the second, we were going to study the different positions of the object corresponding to their image formation. In case of convex, as we have gone through the concave, the rules are the same. The only difference is that in case of concave, focus in the center of curvature, they are lying on the left side of the mirror. So they are real. But in case of convex, your center of curvature and focus, they are lying on the right side of your convex mirror, that is on the back side of the mirror. Hence, they both are imaginary in this case. So first rule is, in case of your this is your convex, this is the back side. First is to draw the principal axis. Let me have my very first rule: when a ray is parallel to the principal axis. In this case, because they both are imaginary, so we will assuming that if a ray is parallel to the principal axis, it is assumed that as it is reflected back from the focus, it appears to be reflected back from the focus. My second rule says that in case of your convex, you have a principal axis. Same rule will going to remain the same. The only differences of the left and right. If a ray is in such a manner incident on the convex, that when we extend it, if it is passes through the center of curvature, then it will going to reflect it back along the same path. If a ray of light is incident on the convex in such a manner that if we extend it on the right side and if it passes through the center of curvature, then it is reflected back along the same path. These were the same rules in concave also, but only difference in the way of presentation. Third rule says that if a ray is incident in such a manner that it appears to be passes through the focus, then the reflected ray is parallel to the principal axis. And my fourth rule says that here, if a ray is incident at an angle I, then it is reflected back with the same angle, that is equal angle of reflection will be equal to the angle of incidence according to my law of reflection, that is I is equal to R. I think all these rules are clear. They are same as in case of concave. The only difference is in the way of presentation, and that is because focus and center of curvature are imaginary in this case. Now, from these rules itself and the way of presentation itself, you can conclude that in case of convex, the image formation will always be imaginary. Here we will going to consider two positions of the object. One is the object lying between pole and infinity, and second is object is at infinity. Make sure that in case of convex, wherever you place your object, at any position, image is always imaginary. The image that is formed using convex is always imaginary. The only difference is in the position of the image and the size of the image. Is this clear? In case of convex, irrespective of the position of the object, image always formed imaginary. The only difference is in the size and the position of your image. So we will going to consider the first case, that's the object lying between pole and infinity. I will going to draw my convex. Here is my convex. Here is my principal axis. This is my focus. This is my center of curvature. This is my object. My first ray is parallel to the principal axis. Then it is assumed to be passing through the center of curvature, focus. And my second ray is passing through the center of curvature, so it is reflected back along the same. So both are, so reflected rays when extended at the back of the convex mirror, they will going to meet at this position. So my object is formed, sorry, image is formed between pole and focus. So the four things that we can conclude here is, first, image formed between pole and focus. Second, imaginary. Third, erect. And fourth, small. Yes or no? You can compare the size of the image. Size of the image is very small as compared to the size of the object. Now let's move on to the next position. Next case is when the object is placed at infinity. Yes, object is at infinity. That is my second case. Here again I will going to draw my convex. Here I have a principal axis. Now since my object is at infinity, I will going to consider the rays are coming from the infinity, so I will not going to draw my object on the principal axis. First ray is assumed to be making an angle I. So it is reflected back in this manner. Let me extend it in the back side. And my second ray is assumed to be like this. It is reflected. Wait, sorry. It is reflected in such a like. If you draw with the help of your scale, you will not going to face this problem. So your image is formed at focus. So what we can conclude, when the object is placed at infinity, even in the case of concave, if you observe that in case of concave also, when the object was at infinity, the image formed at focus. Similarly here also, when the object is at infinity, your image formed at focus. So we can say image is your erect, small, you have it at focus, and it is imaginary. So we have observed here that irrespective of the position of the object, in case of convex, the image formed is always your imaginary. Now is there any use of convex in our daily life? Yes, it is very useful in our daily life. In case of your car, you have seen that your rear side mirror, your rear side mirror is always a convex. Why? Because irrespective of the position of the traffic, the cars that are moving along and at the back of your car, all the car, truck, traffic, whatever vehicle is moving at the back of your car, they are always the image of all those always appear to be the erect, seedhi. Secondly, it has broader, because the size of the object, size of the image formed is very small, so the you can say the view is broadened in case of convex. If we compare it with a plane mirror, you can say in case of plane mirror also, the image is always formed imaginary irrespective of the position of the object. So why we are not using a plane mirror irrespective of the convex mirror? In case of plane mirror, if you observe that the size of the object is, size of the image is same as that of the object, so it will occupy more space, and our view, the view of our sight will going to narrow. But in case of convex, since the size of the object, size of the image becomes very small, so our view extends. in case of convex. That is why convex are used as rear mirrors in case of your cars. Is this clear? Now, if you are provided with three mirrors, that your plane, convex and concave, then how will you distinguish that which one is your plane mirror, which one is your convex mirror and which one is your concave mirror? It is very simple. When you come closer, very close to your mirrors, the plane mirror will going to form the image of the same size. In plane mirror we have same size. Plane mirror we have same size. In case of convex, irrespective of the position, image formed and it is small. Yes or no? And in case of concave, if you have gone through my last video, the very first case when a object is placed between pole and focus, the image formed is virtual and it is very large. So when you bring your face very close to your mirrors, in case of plane mirror, if a same size of your image is formed in a mirror, then it is a plane mirror. If say small size image is formed, then it is convex. And if it is a large image is came out from your mirror, then it is your concave mirror. I think this is clear to everyone. Still, if you have any doubt, you can comment. And please subscribe the channel if you like the video. Thank you.